Ricky Gervais.
Hello.
How's it going?
You all right?
Good to see you again.
Hi.
Hello.
Good to see you. Hi.
Oh, thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you.
I appreciate that you've actually been preparing for this. I saw this picture on Twitter of you in the bathtub with this Viking helmet.
Yeah. That was actually taken in Oslo. I went to get in. I played Oslo and I played Sweden and around your area.
You have these daily, almost daily, pictures on social media that you put out these pictures of yourself very, very often in the bathtub.
Yeah. Well, there's nothing else to do once you've washed everything.
Yeah.
Which for me doesn't take very long, really. Then you know it's a waste of water, so I try and make the most of it. A nice hot bath. And the idea is
so
to
you
look.
So you bring your phone into the bar.
Of course.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's not of course. But,
No. Some people. I've lost a lot of phones to water. But it's so versatile now. It's like you can. It's like being in the office. You know, you've got everything: emails, Twitter, cameras. I do videos.
Yeah.
You know. But it's a hobby.
And not always the most. Forgive me for saying this. Not always the most flattering angle.
Well, no. No, as you can see, close up, I'm quite a hunk. But the idea is to make yourself look as awful as possible. You see, that way, the paparazzi can never get a picture of me as bad as one that I willingly... So when they say, he looks awful, I go, no, this is awful. So it's a self-defence mechanism.
So this is something... You would recommend this for...
I wouldn't recommend it to anyone, really. But no, I.
The ugly selfie.
It's the ugly selfie. It's the way forward.
You do your cats as well, though. I've seen.
Oh, I love my cat.
You love animals. Have you done the research on him and
you
animals?
You see, a cat
Amazing.
Can't look bad. Animals can never look bad. You never see a cat and it goes. I was drunk. It was. They always look perfect. There's not an angle you can get. They're always. All animals are unconditionally beautiful and perfect. But
it makes me like you more that you like animals.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Yeah.
Thank you. If you just saw that, you'd think there's not.
Do I like this guy?
But he loves animals. Oh.
Why do you think when you look at comedians, a lot of comedians do get very famous in their own territory, but your humor travels. Why do you think that is?
Well, I don't know. I think it's because. I don't know. I think my subjects are probably universal. When you're joking about Hitler and famine, you know, everyone gets that. I don't know. I think sometimes people set out to be the biggest person in the territory, so they pander to that territory and then it doesn't travel. Whereas I think if you just do it for yourself and you're passionate and you do deal with... Like, The Office, it looked like a very quintessentially British show. But actually, it was about big universal subjects. You know, it was quite existential what you're doing with your life. It was about bad bosses. It was about being stuck with people that you didn't get on with. It was boy meets girl. It was all those things that we all identify with. And it just the backdrop looked boring. But then, boring is universal. Everyone's bored. Do you know what I mean? So it's about you know the minutiae of life. It's about making the ordinary, extraordinary. So,
what about? I mean, being from time to time offensive to some people, as a comedian, maybe you must. Does it keep you awake at night that people are offended?
No, because you're offended doesn't mean you're right. Some people are offended by gay marriage. Some people are offended by mixed marriage. Some people are offended by my very existence because I don't believe in God. What am I meant to do? You know? Fuck 'em. But I don't go out to offend. I never go out to offend. You don't have to. It's too easy, it's churlish, it's pointless. But there's nothing you can say that someone somewhere won't find offensive. Sometimes they've got a point. The thing is about offences, it's not about right and wrong, it's about feelings, and feelings are personal. So it's about controlling your own emotions. I find things offensive. I find loads of things offensive.
What do you find offensive?
Animal cruelty. It makes my blood boil. I want to batter the person who hurts them. But what can I do except try and educate, you know, or not watch a show that has something I don't like? But I think about words and jokes. I think that's a very different matter. I think that's so subjective. It's like art or taste. I mean, I think... And by its very definition, I think humour should deal with bad subjects, with awful things. I think that's what humour's for. It's to get us through stuff. Evolutionary speaking, we joke about bad things because it gets us... It's a healing process. So when people say, oh, you shouldn't joke about that because it's bad... No, you should joke about that because it's bad. What's the point of joking about good stuff? It's already good. You joke about bad stuff. No harm can come from dealing with taboo subjects. You should be able to joke about anything. It's funny because people say to comedians, is there anything you wouldn't joke about? Yeah. But they don't ask journalists, is there anything you wouldn't write about? And it's the same thing. I think offence comes from people mistaking the subject of a joke with the target of a joke. And that's the important thing. What's the target of the joke?
In your family, I mean, you're like, actually, like me, you have two older brothers and an older sister.
Yeah.
And you're very much younger than your...
Yeah, my older brother's 11 years older than me, my sister's 13 years older than me, and my older brother is 14 years older than me. I remember when I was about 12 or 13, I was eating my cornflakes, and I said to my mum, why are my brothers and sisters so much older than me? And she said, because you're a mistake. Just like that, I just laughed. Very honest. Just very, very honest.
So yeah. You are the love child.
No. I think it was
I
some...
always felt like the love child, but then again, I never asked.
I don't know what it was. It was drunkenness or some sort of birthday present. I have no idea. I'm pretty sure it was the last time they ever did it. I can't imagine. Oh, and now I'm thinking about it. You should never think of your parents doing it.
Yeah.
Oh, God. But it was everything was funny growing up. Everything was just fun and real and honest, and it was great. It's David Brent trying to be a pop star.
I'm not trying to get to the Derek.
sorry, I just ruined
your flow. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I had this wonderful flow.
I'm sorry, Freddie.
Are you in charge?
Well, I used to be.